Hello, I'm Sergey Tarakanov. I'm ex-CSKA player, national player, Olympic champion, world champion, 3 times European champion in basketball. Played 11 years for CSKA, national player, national team of Soviet Union from 79 to 90. And I'm working now for trying to help CSKA with contacts with veteran players of CSKA, responsible for that. I'm president of Veteran Council and Union, trying to organize this work with ex-CSKA players. And also we created this museum. Idea was 2 years ago. We work on it about 1 year. And finally, we opened it a few months ago, and it's kind of to say thank you to most important players of CSKA basketball history. It's not yet finished because we modified a little bit in the future. We will modify this museum. Some ideas will be changed. But in general, it looks like this. We found this place because it was not easy, because the CSKA gym, this gym is not property of CSKA basketball club. The CSKA basketball club is renting this gym from CSKA. How we call Big CSKA, because Big CSKA is unifying many kind of sports, and the Central Sport Club CSKA is main boss of this building, and we found agreement with them to use this space. Now I think it was not bad done. People loves to watch it before the games. It was not easy because the main problem is the lack of artifact, lack of t-shirts, uniform, shoes from past. We tried to collect all the artifacts from ex-players. It was not easy because in those times, first of all, it was not a lot of it. And the second reason, it's because nobody care about it, and a lot of time passed already, and not so many is still existing. We're trying to work on it, still trying to work and collect all these old rarities things. We hope that we will find new one. But in general, it's not easy, I repeat it. I don't know, funny moments. First of all, it was hard work, because not always funny. Of course, we try to make it easier for us, and because 3 times a day we were practicing, and with national team, we almost didn't have a vacation. It was real hard work, and situation in those time in 80s totally different from situation of today, because CSKA today is a professional club where a lot of foreigners playing. It's a real professional club, and in my time it was so-called army club. We were an army, but in general, of course, it was like army was like main sponsor, and we were professional players. We were practicing because you have no time for others. Even you want to study, you want to have a job, but in those time it was not possible, because if you're practicing 3 times a day or 2 times a day, it's really not possible, because you have no power, you have no time, and etc., etc. Of course, it's great memory about victories, about titles, especially with national team, because in the 80s Soviet Union team was dominating in the world with, let's say, with the United States, with Yugoslavia and Soviet Union. And I could say that I'm proud to play for national team 11 years, because in Soviet Union national team was, today it's a national team of 15 countries. Soviet Union consists in, of 15 republic, and now it's 15 countries like Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, Kazakhstan, Ukraine, etc., etc. And it was best players from all these countries. If we would collect now national team, all-star team from all these 15 countries, I would say that it will be great team. And I was playing for that 11 years. It's my proud, and I'm only one of two Russian players from Russia who was playing in 1988 when we won Olympics. So I always consider it as my honor.